is your God? You say Allah. Who is your Prophet? What is your, sorry, what is your religion? You say Islam. And then they will show you a picture of Muhammad. They ask you, who is this man? You say Muhammad. If you give the wrong answer, they beat you, correct?
Yes.
Okay, now do we know how Muhammad looked like?
No.
So what the
that's
idea
why
of
when you're
the, what
but
the idea,
here's the thing.
Okay,
that's
how
why
you
when
know?
I was when I was but here's that's what I asked too. When I was younger and I went to Sunday school, the teacher was like, you can't memorize these questions, no matter, even though you memorize it, your soul will say it. If you're a believer, you're gonna say it quickly and respond quickly. If you're a non-believer, no matter how much you memorize these answers mm-hmm. about Muhammad, about the angel, about, you know, God, no matter how much you memorize these lines, uh-huh. you won't be able to say it, because you're not a believer.
This isn't the question.
So even though you don't know what the Prophet looks like, even though you don't know what he looks like, subhanAllah, you will, like, you'll respond to
so
it.
What the point
because
of the
you'll be a believer that
what
Allah
the point
will,
of the question?
Will let, allow
what
you
if
to
shaitan,
respond. Because
what if shaitan come to me and show my picture to you?
Fil qabr?
Yeah. He bring my picture. I look very ugly, by the way. And then he showed you me, and he said, who is this? You think those are the angels? Right away you say Muhammad.
No, because that's the thing. You're not gonna, it's not you. I mean, it's you saying it, but if you're a believer, you're gonna say it with confidence. You're gonna say it, it's as if somebody is helping you when you say it, because you're gonna be so, it's a different feeling. When you're a believer, it's just gonna come to you naturally. Even though you didn't memorize the lines, or you don't know the end, like you've never heard of the questions before, it's gonna come to you. But that's what it says in, you know, how
so
I was taught.
So
but if you're a non-believer,
one,
no matter how much you know
okay,
the answer,
the
even
the
though
answer?
You know that there's one God, if
okay.
you sinned and you didn't, you know, ask for forgiveness,
mm-hmm.
if the questions are gonna be so hard for you, you're not gonna come up with an answer, and you're gonna get dazzab. That's how I was raised to learn. That when you're a believer, you're just gonna say, you know. It's just like when, on the Day of Judgment, when you, I don't know if you know this, but when you cross, Sirat, you know, al-Mustaqim, that, to cross that thin, it's not a rope, that thin line, you have to cross a thin line, over hellfire.
Mm-hmm.
And the believers are gonna cross it really fast, and the non-believers are gonna do it really slow. It's just that feeling, like when you're a believer, khalas, it's just naturally, it comes to you naturally.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't practice for it, it just comes to you. So that's how
now,
I see it
we,
as...
You know, I was asking you where Muhammad is, you said he's in the grave. Now where is Jesus? Where is Jesus now?
Jesus is gonna, at the judgment, inshallah, he's gonna come, and then
now.
That's when he will die.
I'm saying now.
And
where is Jesus now? Now.
He's raised. Raised for, with God.
He's with God.
He didn't die yet. His body is up with God, and he didn't die. He's still alive.
He is with God. Did you say that?
He's with God.
Correct. Where is Muhammad now? In the grave.
Muhammad, his body's in the grave, I believe.
That's it. His body is him. He's in the grave.
You know, if he died just as any of us would die. He's not. His death
correct.
Is not like.
So now, why
Jesus was raised?
Okay.
But
why
Muhammad,
Jesus?
He died,
is
so
the only one in your book?
Was,
why Jesus is the only one in your book? He is up in heaven. All people die, except Jesus. Give me a reason.
But he will die on the
it
day of judgment.
Matter. He is now with God. Everybody dying. I will die. You will die. All of us, we will end in the grave. Okay? Now, how and why Jesus, now he is more than 2,000 years old as age, and he's still alive. Give me a reason. Why?
It's more of a test.
Test to
especially,
whom?
Well, from what we believe, it's more of a test because nowadays, more people believe that he is, you know, God, and that he has, you know, died for our sins or anything like that.
So what?
But
actually,
what we believe
actually,
is it's,
you are
it's,
making people believe more he is God. You are making people believe more he is God for real when you say he is still alive, because this is another proof to me as a Christian that he's God. Look, even he is not like others. He's alive.
But that's the reason why he's alive, because Christians say that he died on the cross and he didn't die.
It's not,
that's
not,
why
it is not,
every time we see the cross.
But listen.
Because it did not
exist.
But
listen. But this is not how the story happened. Your God Allah saved him before anyone say anything. He saved him. The Muslims say to us, because Allah don't want him to die. Now you are saying to me, because the Christians say he's God, Allah save him?
No. I'm saying it can also be seen as that way, because many Christians believe that he died for the sins. But if they believe that he died for the sins, you know, he's raised up in heaven. How is he dead? And another thing I want to ask you is that I asked Christians this, and they didn't know the answer was, was Jesus' body ever found? And people say his body was found, but that was not Jesus'
body.
That was another man's body.
Listen, how you can find his body if he is raised from death?
If I what?
If he raised from death, how you can find his body?
I'm asking you. I'm asking
the
Christians.
I'm saying
the Christians. Do the Christians know where he was buried?
He raised from death, so you will not find the body there. The Bible says clearly that he raised from his tomb, and he saw three ladies before he appeared to his apostles, showing his arms, that there's nails in there. And then Thomas, who was not believing that Jesus raised when he heard first time, he bowed down to Jesus. He said, "My Lord, my God." Then Jesus said to him, "Now, Thomas, you believe? Because you thee saw? Bless those who see not and believe." So Jesus raised from death. This is why you will not find his body. And this is a proof that Jesus is God. Because how he can raise himself from death? How he can be alive? Jesus said, "Every two of you meet under my name, I will be between them." Which means he exists everywhere.
Right.
God
okay.
is everywhere.
Right.
And this is the proof that Jesus is God. Now, is your God Allah exist everywhere?
In the cross.
Is your God Allah? Is your God Allah exist everywhere? Do you hear me?
But the man was on the cross and he died, and he resembled Jesus, and he did die and he suffered, but that was not Jesus. And
who is the one
what
make,
you said
make,
about
who
him
is
being
the one,
raised
lady,
and
lady,
being
just wait.
On the cross.
Who is
that,
the one?
This
who,
is why I don't believe it. The main reason why I don't.
Okay.
I get.
Hold on,
I don't
hold on.
Trust Christianity is that. God does not suffer. He does not. He
does not?
Is above us, and
do,
he doesn't
do
need
God
to
get
suffer
angry?
For us.
Do God get angry?
Allah gets displeased when we don't bad things.
Do God get
but
angry?
He does not get affected by us. He's not affected by. He doesn't need our deeds. He doesn't need anything from us.
No.
But he gets
first,
happy when we do good.
He
gets
happy.
You know? But
okay. Okay, what make Allah upset?
What makes him what?
What make Allah upset? What make him sad?
Not sad, but what makes him displeased is when we know what's right, yet we do wrong. When we know, you know,
well,
what we
said,
have to do in this life, and yet we do.
Your prophet said, Allah get happy from those who sneeze, and get sad from those who they yawning.
He what?
Allah,
mm-hmm.
He got unhappy
mm-hmm.
from those who do yawning, and Allah like the one who sneeze. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Why Allah like you to sneeze?
Yes,
why Allah? Why Allah get?
Thing.
Hey,
here's the thing, though.
She's sneezing. He's happy now. Why? Give me a reason.
But. You can't put emotions to God because
well, this is what it says. He
you're giving
emotion.
Human qualities in Islam.
It doesn't
matter.
It doesn't matter.
It's not
Allah,
right to give
Allah
human qualities.
Get happy when you sneeze. Why? Allah love those who sneeze. He love you to have a flu. If you have a flu, Allah like you. Do you hear me? Hello?
Yes, continue.
Okay. If you have a flu, Allah like you. The one who sneezes, he have a flu mostly. Why Allah get happy for having flu?
Why does he get happy for
having a flu? Because the one who sneezes most of the time is because he got cold, he have a flu.